I'm back into public session. I'd like to call on the county manager.
Mr. Chairman, commissioners, as we went over it in closed session, for some time, as I told you, I've been looking at purchasing the old Graham School up here on North Main Street, right beside of the county office annex. There we go. And looking at it for the purposes of future expansion of the county, we're okay, I think, right now, but the county is growing, and eventually the county is going to have to look at building more space. In fact, we could even use more now, but I think when the old ESS building is opened, it'll help us for a while. And I'm looking 5, 10, 15 years from now, maybe a governmental complex somewhere, bringing as many departments together as possible so people can go in one area to reach most of the county departments. And eventually, we're going to need more courtroom space here in Graham, and these buildings right here could easily be turned into courtroom space. But the track there where the old school is about 3 acres. The school building itself, in my opinion, is in pretty bad shape. But the land adjoins our 2.742 acres next to it. The ball field belongs to the county. We have it leased to Graham Parks and Recreation right now, but that's, I think, a 30-day notice lease with them. And I don't think that it would be used anytime soon, but after looking at it for a long time and going through the process, I got Bulldog Albright involved in it, and he has come up with negotiations with the future owners. It's in bankruptcy right now, but I think the future owners are pretty definite. And we have an offer to purchase signed by them for this tract of land in the amount of $550,000. And it's my recommendation to the board that for future development, whether to raise that building and sow it in grass for 5, 10, 15, even 20 years, and do it, because you're not going to find a tract of land any better suited for a governmental center in the future. I would certainly ask the board to seriously consider entering into this purchase agreement, Mr. Chairman.
David, what's the tax value on the property?
$1.3 million at the present time. I think that's really very high, because the school building where did we go? Oh, there it is up at the, is that it?
That's the courthouse at the bottom.
Yeah, there it is. That's how far we are from the middle of downtown now, and the our courthouse. $1.3 million, Mr. Chairman, is what we have it on the tax books for. I sent one of our appraisers out not long ago, and they came back with an appraisal somewhere between $400,000 for the land. So I think we're in the ballpark. There's not a tract, as far as I can tell, anywhere in the city of Graham that large. And with the tract we already own, it's just an excellent opportunity, I think, that the county probably will never have again.
Okay. Any discussion with the board?
Right.
That would not have to be rezoned.
Clyde, do you know what the zoning is? I read it, but I can't remember what it was.
It's institutional now.
Institutional.
I assume it would be about the same, yeah.
It would be the same, essentially the same use.
Sammy, are you familiar with back when there was some talk of, as you go north or northwest on that road, you've got that sharp curve to the left and then the sharp curve back to the right, and you go to the railroad tracks and go over into Fairchild area. Are you familiar with when there were some plans to straighten that out and widen it and have a bridge or a underpass, a tunnel going over into East Burlington. And that was, those plans were scrapped, but. Is it on a drawing board anywhere that you know of, DOT?
I think I was on the TAC at that time, Tim, and I think part of the issue was the historical church. Providence Church, yeah. And tried to straighten it. It went through some of their property or part of the cemetery or whatnot. Okay. And then it was going to be very expensive to put an overpass to go over the railroad track. And then, too, it funneled all that truck traffic right into downtown Burlington. I mean, downtown Grant. So I think that pretty much killed that idea back then. But I think the neighborhood there on North Main Street would be greatly relieved to know that property is in county ownership because of the uncertain nature of it, especially right now and what it's been in the recent past. And that it would be maintained and be an asset to the neighborhood. But it is a long-range plan, and it'd be hard to put together a tract of land that size in the urban area of Graham, probably at that price. I'll make a motion that the county purchase the property for $550,000. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Is there any further discussion? Not all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay, motion carries. No further business. We'll adjourn the meeting. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Typically, the first meeting of the month is held at 9 a.m. and the second meeting is held at 7 p.m. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the Commissioners on the second and fourth Friday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 3 p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching Commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says County Commissioners to visit the Commissioners' website, where you can learn about our Commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners' meeting.